Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. To the members of Bethlehem and our visitors that are streaming with us, we just want to take a few minutes to welcome you to Bethlehem. Is that all right? Come on, put your hands together. Come on. Come on, if you believe in the Lord for better, put your hands together. Hey. Everybody sing. Everybody sing.
Better.
Believe in the Lord.
Believe in the Lord for better.
Yes, hey, everybody sing.
Better.
Thank God.
Better.
In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Say better.
Better.
Believe in the Lord.
Family, this is the day that the Lord has made. His word commands us to rejoice and be glad in it. Listen, we thank you so much for joining us on this morning. On behalf of myself, Pastor Thomas, as well as the leadership of the Bethlehem Baptist Church, we thank you for joining us. We don't believe it's by accident that you're watching, but we know it's by God's divine providence that God has ordered your steps to this broadcast at this time. And so we believe that your life is going to be thoroughly impacted on today. So listen, we want to pause to the calls right now and pull up and allow you to become a virtual evangelist. We want you to love it, and we want you to share this broadcast. If you're watching on YouTube, come on, copy the link and send it to Lottie Dottie and everybody. Listen, God is doing wonderful things in this season. We want you to understand that it is your time to recover.
Hallelujah. Welcome, welcome. Come on, just begin to bless the Lord with us. Somebody tell him thank you. Hallelujah. Lord God, you're worthy. Hallelujah. Glory, honor, and praise. We thank you for keeping us all week long, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that you inhabit our praise and you inhabit our worship. And Lord God, go before us on today as we lift you up, as we magnify you, as we seek to know you better. Hallelujah. Dwell with us. Be in the midst of your people, right where they are, Lord God. In their homes, in their cars, wherever they are, Lord God. Touch, Lord God. Move by your spirit, Lord God. The Destroy every yoke. Destroy every bind, Lord God. Break every yoke in the name of Jesus. And we thank you, Lord God, that you're moving on our behalf on today. Stir us up to where you want us to be, oh God. Speak, Lord. Say what you want to say and do what you want to do. And I declare freedom in this atmosphere. Hallelujah. Receive freedom on today. Glory to God. Put them hands together and give God a praise.
Ta-da!
bless the Lord. Begin the worship. We thank you, Lord. We thank you for the victory. We thank you for liberty. Have your way in our lives.
By his stripes we are healed. By his nail-pierced hands we're free. By his blood we're washed clean. Now we have the victory. The power of sin is broken. Jesus overcame it all. He has won our freedom. Jesus, you have won it all. Everyone declare. Say hallelujah. You have won.
You have won the victory.
Say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You won it all for me.
You have won it all for me.
And death could not hold.
Death could not hold you.
Hallelujah, you are the victorious King.
You are the risen King.
You're seated in majesty.
Seated in majesty.
You alone are the risen King.
You are the risen King.
Hallelujah, say yeah.
Hallelujah.
You have won.
You have won the victory.
Declare, say hallelujah. victory. You reign forever. You rule forever. Ha! You reign forever.
Won the victory.
You reign on high.
Our God, who is alive.
He is alive.
You
won the victory. You reign on high. You up, oh God. Move in the midst of your people, oh God. As we have to offer up a sacrificial worship. Meet every need. Break every yoke. Destroy every yoke, oh God. Everything that's in us that you don't want, oh God. Cleanse us, renew us, oh God. Restore us, oh God. Hallelujah, we thank you for healing. Hallelujah, we thank you that where your presence is, sickness cannot dwell, oh God. Where your presence is, hallelujah, depression cannot continue to exist, oh God. Where you are, Lord God, every infirmity must go, oh God. So, Lord God, right now as we offer up our worship, you, Lord God, will restore to us everything, Lord God, that we have poured out on today. You move in our families, Lord God, like a mighty wind, oh God, upon our children, upon our spouses, oh God, upon our family, Lord God, upon this building, hallelujah, in this church, hallelujah, believers, this body of believers, oh God, upon our pastor, Lord God, upon his family, Lord God, upon the musicians, oh God, we thank you, Lord God, for being with us, oh God, we thank you for dwelling with us, oh God, we will not lose anything in this season, but Lord God, you will restore to us what we have lost in the past, Lord God, and we thank you, Lord God, for restoration, Lord God, in our physical body. We thank you for restoration in our finances. We thank you for restoration in our marriages. We thank you for restoration in every area of our lives, Lord God. And we thank you, Lord God, that our heart, the hearts of your people are turning to you. The hearts of our children are turning to you. You said if we will raise them up, Lord God, according to your standards, according to your word, Lord God, that they will not depart from it. So, Lord God, we declare, Lord God, our children are saved in the name of Jesus. They shall know you intimately for themselves. Hallelujah. They shall know your ways intimately, hallelujah, Sunday, and they shall desire truth, oh God. And so, God, I thank you, Lord God, that you have inhabited our praise. You have inhabited our worship. You have stepped in this atmosphere, oh God. And even if we can't feel everything, Lord God, we know that you're moving. If we can't see it, Lord God, we still know that you're moving. We still know that you're shifting under the Most High, and you're working it out for our good. You're working it out for our good, for you're not a man that you should lie, neither the son of man that you have to repent, because you keep your promises. You keep your promises. You keep your promises. So, Lord God, we receive on today everything that you have for us. Receive it, receive it, receive it, receive it. Hallelujah.
Greetings and welcome to Bethlehem Baptist Church. Today's announcements are as follows. Have you downloaded the Givelify app? This app allows you to sow no matter where you are and no matter what time of day. As we know, when we sow into fertile ground, we can expect a harvest. This app will make giving easier. Remember, with Givelify, you can give any amount, anytime, and anywhere. So download Givelify, add Bethlehem as your church, and sow today. Bethlehem family, stay prepared to open COVID-19 vaccinations. Please go to www.myvaccinegeorgia.com to register. That's www.myvaccinegeorgia.com to register. Attention graduating high school and college seniors. Please contact Paulette McLeod with your information at pbmcleod7@gmail.com.
Hey family, listen, we are at the conclusion of our fast. Listen, we're less than 1 week away from our fast being concluded. Can you believe it? Wow, it has gone by. Time has literally flown by. So listen, I want to just encourage you for these last few days to finish strong. Listen, if you fasted with us in any shape, form, or fashion, God honors your efforts and God is pleased even with your attempt. But guess what? Even if you haven't fasted with us, you can go ahead and hop on even now and you can finish strong with us. So listen, at the conclusion of our seven last words service, which is this Friday, the ministers of Bethlehem are going to do a phenomenal job. I'm so excited about that. But at the conclusion of that service, our fast is going to end. That's right. At the amen and at the benediction, the fast is over. So listen, I want to encourage you on today to finish strong. God is well pleased with you and God honors your efforts.
This concludes today's announcements. For more information, please visit our website at www.BethlehemBaptistCovingtonGA.com. Also, like and follow us on Facebook at Bethlehem Baptist Church Covington GA. That's Bethlehem Baptist Church Covington GA. We will now have the word from the pastor of Bethlehem Baptist Church, Pastor Ronnie Thomas Jr.
Hallelujah. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. We give God all the honor. We give God all the praise that is due unto him. Hallelujah. Come on, let us pray. Father, we love you. We thank you, God, for all things, God. You're worthy of all the praise. You're worthy of your honor. You're worthy of the glory. Say thank you now, God, for our mere existence, because our existence is a testimony. It says that every attack from the enemy has been canceled. And because it's been canceled, God, we're on schedule to arrive, God. And so, God, we say thank you now, God, that the best is still yet to come. Thank you now, God, for what's on the way, God. Thank you now, God, for what you're doing in our lives in this season, God. So God, we thank you for the prayers that have been prayed on our behalf, for the songs that have been rendered. Now, God, it's preaching time. I pray now, oh God, that you would decrease me to nothing. Please raise your spirit to everything. Allow me to think with your thoughts, speak with your words. I pray, I beg, I ask now for pulpiteering power, spiritual stamina, effective communication to the saints. Have your way even now. Hide me behind the illuminating shadows of Calvary's cross, that people will see none of me but all of you. Release a word on today, God. Push us, God. Preach us. Move us, God. God, to that place that you would have us to be. We bind the enemy, God. We come against every wandering thought, God. We come against anything that will hinder your word from reaching its ultimate destination, which is the hearts of your people. Speak clearly, please. We need a word on today, a word like fish need water, like bird need air. So do it for us now, God. Let no weapon formed in this hour prosper. Thank you now, God. Thank you for what you're getting ready to do. Hallelujah. God, preach me to the point of your pleasure, till heaven is happy and hearts are being satisfied. Do it for us now, God. Give us, oh God, the growth while you get the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Well, God bless you. God bless you. Hallelujah. God bless you. We greet you in the joy of Jesus. Happy Palm Sunday to you. There is a word that we want to share that is in line with this particular day. Luke chapter 19, verses 28 through 40. Luke chapter 19, verses 28 through 40. Hallelujah. And the word of the Lord records that after Jesus said this, he went on ahead going to Jerusalem. As he approached Bethpage and Bethany at the hill called the Mount of Olives, he sent two of his disciples, saying to them, "Go to the village ahead of you. As you enter, you'll find a coat tied there, which no one has ever ridden. Untie it and bring it here." And verse 31, "If anyone asks you why you're untying it, tell him the Lord needs it." Those who were sent ahead went and found just as he had told them. And as they were untying the coat, its owners asked, why are you untying the coat? They replied, "The Lord needs it." Verse 35, they brought it to Jesus. They threw their cloaks on the coat and put Jesus on it. As he went along, the people spread their cloaks on the road. When he came near the place where the road goes down the Mount of Olives, the whole crowd of disciples began joyfully to praise God in a loud voices for all the miracles that they had seen, saying, "Blessed be the King that cometh in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory on the highest." The Pharisees were there and among the multitude, and they said, "Master, our teacher, rebuke your disciples." And he answered them and said unto them, "I tell you that if one of these should hold their peace, the stones would immediately cry out." And with that thought in mind, certainly needing your prayers, God's power, and the aid of the Holy Spirit, I want to preach on this Palm Sunday this morning. I'm being prepared for my assignment. Would you just do me a favor and just utter these words to somebody, that this is preparation for my assignment? You didn't do it the right way. Come on, just tell them, this is preparation for my assignment. My brothers and sisters, our sermonic spotlight, it marks a very meaningful moment in the life and ministry of Jesus Christ. For up until now, he's been pictured as the suffering servant, as the Anglos of Yahweh, the Lamb of God that has come to take away the sins of the world. But Jesus now is about to shift in nomenclature, that he will no longer be referred to as the Lamb of God, but now Jesus is going to be referred to as the King of Glory. Not in a sense that Jesus would never be called the Lamb of God again, but this marks a shift in his nomenclature. This marks a shift in his identity to his followers, that now he will be known as the King of Glory. And before I go any further, my brothers and sisters, I want to say that this is vitally important, how we view Jesus Christ. Because how we view Jesus Christ not only speaks to the fact that we know and note him as King, but the way we view Jesus Christ, it also reveals to us things about ourselves. Whenever we have the appropriate revelation of Jesus Christ, it informs who, in fact, that we are. Our Christology, which is how we view Christ, impacts our anthropology, and our anthropology affects our sociology, our Christology, how we view Christ. It impacts our anthropology, how we view others, and ultimately impacts our anthropology, how we view ourselves, and our sociology of how we view others. So the way that we view Christ impacts us as well as our surroundings, because whenever you view Jesus Christ as King, you view Christ with a kingdom consciousness, that whenever you understand that Jesus Christ is the King of glory, whenever your Christology is such that it impacts your anthropology, the way you view yourself, and your sociology, the way you view others, you understand, watch this, that you have a kingdom consciousness. And because you have a kingdom conscious, you're not limited by labels. Because you have a kingdom conscious, you know who Christ is. And because you know who he is, subsequently, watch this, you know who you are. And people that know who Jesus is can hold their head up in the face of criticism. People that know who Jesus Christ is don't have to worry. People that know who Jesus Christ is don't have to bear unnecessary burdens and cry unnecessary tears and walk unnecessary floors and deal with trivial things in life, because you know who Jesus Christ is. And so Jesus is now preparing for his assignment. He's preparing for his assignment in the earth. And one thing that we discover about his assignment is that his assignment took some preparation. Can the church say preparation? Thank you. And just how Jesus Christ, his assignment took some preparation, the same goes for you and I. And so when I look at this particular text, my brothers and sisters, that Jesus Christ is on the road to destiny. Jesus has already set his face toward Jerusalem. Jesus Christ is now pointing to what he was ultimately born to do, which was he was born to die, because the sin problem had become so bad that the sin problems of bullock and goats were no longer sufficient. And so there had to be a ransom. There had to be an atonement made, and that is Jesus Christ. So Jesus is being prepared now for his assignment. He's preparing for his assignment. And so as I looked at this text before us microscopically, there were a couple of things that I saw in this text that Jesus used to prepare for his assignment. And I want to suggest that the same things that Jesus did to prepare for his assignment are the same things that you and I must do to prepare for our assignment. Because before I go any further, everybody who's watching me now or who will watch later, you must understand that you have an assignment, that God has birthed you into this earth, that God has birthed you into this life to carry out an intended purpose. And oftentimes, just because we're here does not mean that the assignment is going to automatically happen. And so Jesus, watch this, prepares for his assignment. And so when I look at this text, my brothers and sisters, the first thing that Jesus Christ needed as he prepared for his assignment, and the first thing that you and I must need, is that we must be surrounded, watch this, by faithful participants. Just tell your neighbor, if you're sitting beside somebody, says, I know that's right, that you have to have some faithful participants. And before I go further, I want to let you know that your environment matters, that the people around you matter, that the people that are around you can push you toward your destiny or pull you down toward your demise. Your environment matters. In order for Jesus, watch this, to carry out his assignment in the earth, Jesus needed, watch this, faithful participants. And just like Jesus needed faithful participants, you and I, we've got to have some faithful people and participants around us. Watch this, because watch this, just how Jesus needed somebody to help him carry out his assignment in terms of doing those things that were needful and necessary, you and I need them too. So many times we think, beloved, that we are the Lone Ranger, that we don't need anybody else, that we can do it all on our own. But the devil is a liar, because everybody needs somebody. Y'all not talking to me. I'm getting on to point number one. Everybody needs somebody. Y'all ain't talking to me. Batman had Robin, Catney had Lacey. Help me, God. Everybody needs somebody. You got to have faithful participants. And watch this, when we look at this text, Now, brothers and sisters, in verse 29 through verse 31, watch it in the text. It says, as he approached Bethpage and Bethany at the hill called the Mount of Olives, he sent two of his disciples, saying to them, watch this, go to the village ahead of you, and as you enter it, you'll find a colt tied there, which no one has ever ridden. He says, untie it, watch this, and bring it to me. Watch this, here it is. Jesus says, if anyone asks you why you're untying it, tell them that the Lord has need of it. Jesus had to have with him faithful participants. Watch this. Jesus had to have people with him, watch this, that would listen closely. Jesus instructed his followers to do two things. Number one, they had to listen closely. But after they listened closely, then, watch this, they were able to loose the coat. Watch this. They couldn't loose the coat until they first listened closely. Watch this. Here it is. Jesus says to them, he gives them strict instructions. He says, I told you where to go. Watch this, and what to do. You have to have people around you that are going to help you. You got to have people around you that are going to follow through. You got to have people around you that have your best interest at heart. You got to have faithful participants. And somebody today, you're watching me and you're asking me the question, how do I determine who is right in my life? How do I determine who should be stationed in my life? How do I determine who should be in my life? Who I should give an eviction notice out of my life? Well, I can tell you how you can determine. You can always determine if that person is needful in your life because of what happens after you hook up with them. Preach, Pastor, I'm doing the best I can. You can tell if that person is God ordained in your life because of what happens after your life. Help me, God. If a hell broke loose after I hooked up with you, that's an indication that you're not designed to be in my life. Because whenever you get the right person in your life, in the words of Biggie Smalls, you're supposed to be riding better now, driving better now, coochie sweaters now. Whenever you get the right people around you, they should elevate you. Whenever the right people are around you, they will push you to your destiny. And I don't know who I'm talking to today, but God is telling me to tell somebody that you need to have faithful participants around you. As you go towards your destiny and as you prepare for your assignment, you got to check your crew. And this ain't the season to have everybody around you. This ain't the season to have people around you that don't have your best interest at heart. You got to have faithful participants. Why? Because the assignment is too critical. Y'all ain't talking to me. The assignment is too critical. Watch this, time is running short. Because at this time, Jesus didn't have much time left. And so he didn't have time to teach at that point. He didn't have time to coddle at that point. He didn't have time to explain at that point. He needed people around him that will listen carefully and that will be able to loose the coat. Would you do me a favor? If you're sitting beside somebody, would you ask them a favor? Say, can you help me loose the coat? Because it's the coat that's going to ride me to destiny. It's the coat that's a part of my life. God says, I need people around you to end this season that's going to help you loose the coat. Watch this. He had faithful participants around him to help him. Preach, Pastor, I'm trying to help him loose the coat. Watch this. And somebody, you're watching, you want to ask a text the question, well, why didn't Jesus loose the coat on his own? Well, it wasn't his assignment to loose the coat. Y'all ain't talking to me. When you got the right people around you, you don't have to do everything. When you got the right people around you, you got people, watch this, that can see, that can anticipate a need before it happens. That's the kind of people that you got to have in your life. You got to have the kind of people that are going to anticipate a need before it ever transpires. You don't like that? Come here, let me show it to you in the scripture. When you go into Exodus, here it is, Israel. They're in a battle. Watch this. And Moses, Aaron, and Ur are at the top of the hill, while Joshua and all are in the battle, in the valley fighting physically. Moses is up on the top of the mountain praying. But watch this, when his hands are up, help me God, Israel is winning. But what Aaron and Ur notice is that when his hands begin to drop, Israel Israel begin to lose. Watch this, in that dialogue, in that pericope, there was no conversation between Moses, Aaron, and Ur. But what they do instinctively, help me God, is they lift up his hands. And that's how the kind of people that you got to have around you. You got to have the kind of people that can see and anticipate a need. You need people around you that are going to help you loose the code. Would you do me a favor? And if you're sitting beside somebody and say, are you a faithful participant? Help me, God. Are you going to help me in this season? Y'all ain't talking to me. Are you going to help me in this season? Are you going to push me towards my destiny? Are you somebody that I can count on? Because I have discovered, as some of you have as well, that everybody that you count, you can't count all. Y'all ain't talking to me on today. And so here it is. You got to have the right kind of people around you. You got to have the right kind of people that are going to listen carefully. You got to have the right kind of people that are going to loose the coat. You got to have people that are going to push you to that place that God says you can be. Oh, God, on today. You got to have people around you that say, I see more in you than you see in yourself. You got to have people around you that are going to affirm your destiny. You got to have people around you that's going to lay prostrate for you. You got to have people around you that's going to turn down their plate for you. You got to have people around you that are going to pray for you in order to be everything that God says you're going to be. You got to have some faithful participants. Would you do me a favor and say, neighbor, oh God, I can't do this on my own. Say, neighbor, I can't do this on my own. That I need some faithful participants around me. And so here it is, Jesus. Watch this. He is being prepared for his assignment. He's preparing for his assignment. And watch this. Here it is. The one thing that he needed. He needed faithful participants around him. Oh gosh, he needed faithful participants. He needed people, watch this, that were able to listen closely. Watch this. He needed people that were able to internalize what it was that he was saying. He needed people around him that could hear his words, watch this, and then act on his words. He needed the people around him that would listen closely, but not only would they listen closely, they would follow through and loose the coat. Oh gosh, I gotta run on to point number two. I'm doing two and then I'm through on today, and then I'll see you next week on Easter Sunday right here, same station, same time. But Jesus, watch this, he had to have faithful participants. Not only, beloved, watch this, when you're prepared for your assignment, must you be surrounded by faithful participants? Watch this. You got to be surrounded by the right people. You got to have people that'll listen closely. But not only will they listen closely, they'll turn around and loose the coat. In other words, you got to have people around you that want to see you win. You got to have people around you that want to see you become everything that God says you can be. You got to have people around you that don't have the crab in the barrel mentality. Because the crab in the barrel mentality says, watch this, as long as I got more than you, y'all ain't talking to me. As long as I've got more than you, help me God, we're good. As long as I got more than you, I can cheer you on. Help me God, as long as my car is better than your car, I can cheer you on. As long as, help me God, my job is better than your job, I can cheer you on. As long as, help me God, I'm here and you're there, I can cheer you on. But the minute you try to get level up with me, the minute that you try to exceed me, the crab in the barrel mentality begins to pull you back down. And I don't know who I'm talking to on today, but God says you got to sure enough sanitize your surroundings. God, deliver me from competitive people. Jesus, on today, this ain't the seat to have people around you that are competitive. You see, some of you have got people around you that you think are your friends, but here it is, watch this, they're just watching you, and they're just watching you, getting closer to you, trying to one up you. And you know, watch this, they got a spirit of competition on them when they say, oh, if it was me, I would just do that. Oh, if it was me, it don't take all that. The devil is a liar. It takes all of this and then some. If you ain't around me to listen carefully, if you ain't around me to loose a coat, may the doorknob hit you. Help me, God, where the good Lord split you and the dog should have bit you. You got to have faithful participants in your life. Faithful participants. Watch this. You got to have faithful participants. You're being prepared for something. You're being prepared for something that's great. I don't know who I'm talking to. Somebody, you need to catch this word. You're starting a business venture. Somebody, you're an entrepreneur at heart. Somebody, you're doing something. But God says you got to have the right people around you. God says what you're doing is going to impact a generation to come. But you got to have the right people around you. You got to have faithful participants that will listen carefully. And then you got to have faithful participants that will loose the coat. So in other words, you got to be surrounded by faithful participants. But not only must you be surrounded by faithful participants, here it is. Watch this in the text. Here it is. You have to surrender. Watch this. The fullness of praise. To do me a favor and says, neighbor, you have to surrender the fullness of praise. Oh, God, yes, you got to have faithful participants. But then there is the fullness of praise. You have to, watch this, surrender. Watch this, the fullness of praise. Watch this in the text. Watch this. Here it is. Jesus, watch this. It's now. Here it is. The donkey has been brought to him. Jesus now has been set on the donkey. They put their coats out. And now, watch this. Jesus is riding through. And so now the people begin to praise him. And I don't know who I'm talking to today, but somebody, fullness of praise is a part of the process. So somebody, the fullness of praise, it is a part of the process. Because watch this, they praise him in two ways. They praise him, watch this, before he arrives. Here it is. I don't know who I'm talking to, but somebody, you got to praise him before he arrives. Watch the text says, when they came near the place, watch this, where the road was, goes down the Mount of Olives, the whole crowd of disciples begin to joyfully praise God in loud voices. You missed it. Here it is. Watch this. When he came near. In other words, he was not even there yet. They began to praise him before he arrived. And I don't know who I'm talking to on today. God is telling me to tell somebody that you have to begin to praise him before he arrives. Yes, he's made a promise, but God says, before I provide the promise, I want the proper praise. Did you hear what I just said? God says, yes, I provided a promise in your life, but before, watch this, I provide the promise, here it is, I need you to release the proper praise. Here it is, the people will praise him before he arrives. Now, he hasn't even gotten there yet. Come here. Here's the point to make it applicable to you. I hear God telling me to tell you that in your life, you got to give him praise before he even does it. You got to give him praise before he even makes a way. You got to give him praise before he opens the door. You got to give him praise before he heals your body. You got to give him praise before he makes a way out of no way. You got to give him praise before he opens the right door. You got to give him praise before he shuts the wrong door. You got to give him praise before he sends the right people. You got to give him praise before he exits the wrong people. You got to give him praise before he arises. And I don't know who I'm talking to today, but I hear God telling me to tell you to go ahead and get in a posture of praise, because he's getting close. Would you do me a favor and turn to that neighbor and give them a virtual high five? Oh gosh, I feel like I'm getting ready to go. Would you do me a favor, turn to that neighbor and give him a virtual high five and say, neighbor, he's getting close. Here it is. The text says, when he drew near, they began to praise him. And so I don't know who I'm talking to on today, but somebody should give God praise. He says, the only thing that you're lacking, here's the fullness of praise. And so here it is, beloved. And then we're going to get out of here. They gave him praise based off of his before he arrived. But then, beloved, they gave him praise because he's almighty. Would you do me a favor really quickly? Type in the comment section that he is almighty. Come on, type quicker than that. That he is almighty. Because here it is in verse 38. Watch what it says. It says, blessed is the king who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in the heaven and glory in the highest. And so here it is, my brothers and sisters. When you look at this text, it shouts me. Because here it is, they said, blessed be the King. Oh, Jesus. That word, the King, is a definite article, because there were many other small K kings throughout history. But here it is, beloved. They had sense enough to understand that he was almighty, and they're going to bless him just because he was almighty. And so that's all a child of God needs to know, is that the God you serve, that the King of glory, Christ of Yeshua, is almighty. And so I don't know who I'm talking to, but I believe I'll get off right there. I just wanted to tell you what the Lord is doing in your life, that he's preparing you. He's preparing you for something, but you got to surround yourself with faithful participants. Would you do me a favor and say, I have to surround myself with faithful participants? But not only must I surround myself with faithful participants, according to the text, I got to surrender the fullness of praise. Would you do me a favor and tell your neighbor, neighbor, I'm going to praise him. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, I'm going to lift him up, because my praise is predicated on the breath of my body. Come here, David. David said, everything that has breath should praise the Lord. And I don't know who I'm talking to, but I believe today there's about 15, 25, 30, 40 people watching that have made up in their mind that God is worthy of the praise. You made up in your mind that he's worthy of the honor. You made up in your mind that he's worthy of the glory. And if you know that he's worthy of praise, and if you know he's worthy of honor, and if you know he's worthy of the best you have, don't wait until the battle is over. Don't wait until the victory is won, but praise him right now. And that's all I wanted to tell you, that God is preparing you for your assignment, but you gotta be surrounded by faithful participants. But not only must you be surrounded by faithful participants, you have to surrender the fullness of praise. And so that's all, y'all. I'm gonna exit left stage. Bye-bye, y'all. See you next week. May the Lord bless you real good. Be not, yeah, dismayed. Whatever be tied beneath his wings of love abide. God, I said God, he will take care of you. Do me a favor. Somebody in your house that you can rejoice with and sing, neighbor, I know he will take care of me. I may have to cry, but I know he will take care of me. I may be sick, but I know he will take care of me. I may be down to my last dime, but I know he will take care of me. And because I know he'll take care of me, I'm going to surrender the fullness of praise. I'll praise him in the morning. I'll praise him in the evening. I'll praise him at night, because he's worthy of the Lord. In fact, the Bible says, let the redeemed of the Lord say so. And if there's anybody that's redeemed out there, if there's anybody that's been dipped in the blood, if there's anybody that's been washed, I double dog dare you to give God a crazy praise. Bless him in your house. Bless him in your car. Bless him in your living room. Give him everything that he deserves. And when you give him everything that he deserves, what you discover is that he will make a way. He will turn it around. He will turn your frown into a smile. He will do it for you. But you gotta believe. I don't know who I'm talking to, but God is telling me to tell you, you've been prepared for a purpose. You've been preserved for a purpose. That's why the accident didn't kill you. That's why you didn't lose your mind. That's why, out of everything that you've been through, you are
are, you're still standing. Yes, you're hurt. Yes, you're confused. Yes, you're sad. But you are, you're still standing. Handicapped, you're still standing. The best, I said the best, it is yet to come. Please do me a favor. Turn to that neighbor and say, neighbor, please, please be patient with me. God, I said, God is not through with me yet. God is not through with me yet. And because he's not through with me yet, everything, every time I get a chance, I'ma surrender the fullness of praise. Say, yeah, yeah. Because he's able, because he's made a way, because he can do it. I will bless the name of the Lord. Oh, I know he's all right. Would you do me a favor? Oh God, would you repeat after me? I may not know one thing, I may not know two things, but I know he's all right. Woo! Do me a favor one more time. Let me close this thing out. Tell your neighbor, says neighbor, I may not know one thing, I may not know two things, but I know he's all right. Hallelujah. And if you know he's all right, give him the praise, give him the honor. Yeah! Yeah! Yes!
He is. He's preparing you. You gotta have surrounded with faithful participants. You gotta have people that wanna see you win. You gotta be surrounded by people that wanna see you win. But not only must you have be surrounded with faithful participants, you got to surrender the fullness of praise. You got to surrender the fullness of praise. I want to pray. Father, we love you. Thank you now. What our eyes have seen. Thank you, God, for the word that has been released. We pray, oh God, that it would, in fact, fall on the fertile ground of our hearts to be our next and newest reality. So we love you, Lord. We pray now that you will give us the sense, the discernment to surround ourselves with faithful participants, people that will listen closely to us and people that will loose the coat for us. And then, God, help us surrender to you the fullness of praise. We thank you for it, God. Thank you for it, God. We ask this in the matchless, the miracle-working name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. Listen, the doors of the church are open. If you're out of the ark of safety, if you don't know Jesus in the free pardon of your sin, listen, we offer Christ to you. It's as simple as admitting, believing, and then subsequently confessing. Hallelujah. On today, we offer Christ to you. We offer Christ to you. We offer Christ to you. You can inbox us. You can call the church. You can comment below. Listen, if you need a church home, I want to be a pastor. Our deacons would love to be your deacons. Our mothers would love to be your mothers. We want to push you to that place that God says you can be. I want you to have everything that God says that you can have. Hallelujah on today. Well, listen, we're moving forward in our services. There's no worship experience complete without the presentation of a gift. So to that end, we pray now that you would in fact give back a portion of that which God has given unto you. The Bible says that God loves a cheerful giver, one that gives with a hilarious heart. And so God wants you to give on today. God wants you to trust him on today. God wants you to prove him. God wants you to take him at his word. Hallelujah. Somebody today, God wants you to take him at his word as it relates to your giving. So while you're getting that seed, I want to help you attach an expectation to it. Father, we love you. We thank you now for these seeds that are being sown. We pray now, God, that it would, in fact, God, be that seed that will break the back of the enemy, that it will be that seed that will unlock generational favor, God, in the name of Jesus. Do it for them now, God. God, when they release, God, let them receive 100-fold. We love you and we thank you, God. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Well, God bless you, family. God bless you. We thank you so much for joining us on this morning. We pray all is functioning well with you. Hallelujah. Those of us, those that are on the fast with us, listen, it's coming to an end. It's coming to an end. Praise God. This Friday, at the conclusion of our seven last word service, the fast is coming to an end. Praise God on today. To that end, once more, I want you to tune in, everybody to tune in this Friday. Praise God. At 7 p.m., our ministers of Bethlehem, they're going to present to us the seven last words, hallelujah, of Christ from the cross. So this Friday, April 2nd at 7 p.m., I ask that you will tune in. And at the conclusion of that service, our fast will conclude for 2021. And I pray that throughout the calendar year, it's just going to be April when we're ending the fast. And I pray that throughout the calendar year that you will turn the plate down, you and God. Hallelujah. But we, once a year, we come together corporately as a family, as a church body. And we fast together. Hallelujah. Well, God bless you. Hey, it's your season. It's your year to recover. I want you to know that God is not done yet. God is not done yet. God has great things on the horizon. God has great things in store for you. Listen, I love you. Stay strong. Stay encouraged. Come on, let's receive our final prayer and benediction simultaneously. Father, we love you. We thank you for everything that our eyes have seen and that our ears have heard. We thank you for the favor that has been released, God, today. Thank you for the word that has been released on today, God. Please bless us and keep us. It is our prayer that every good thing that comes to our mind shall come to pass. Everything that our hand touch shall be blessed, God, in the name of Jesus. Do it for us now. Keep us and cover us, God. It is our prayer, Father. We pray that you withhold no good thing from us. Everything that our hand touch once more and our comes to our mind, God, will be our portion and our footsteps, they're favored, oh God, hallelujah. And they have fortune in our future. So we love you and we thank you and we bless your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. God bless you, family. God bless you. Listen, we'll see you. We'll see you next week. We'll see you Wednesday and Friday. And then we'll see you again for our resurrection service. We pray many blessings and bountiful blessings for you. It's your time to recover. Be encouraged.